Hello, this is
Father Illuminato
of the Heaven's Gate Collection Agency, and I've been finding evil hidden messages recorded backwards in U2 songs. Women of Toronto, I received more response to my previous ad than I could possibly hope to contend with in the next couple of weeks of my busy schedule. But if you would like to contact Father Illuminato at box 14102 and confess, my child, how much you hate ridiculous rock and roll outfit U2 and divulge the details of how you would personally like to humiliate and abuse any member of this band, Father, I will follow.
I mean, Father, I will record your response.
God bless you.
This is not a joke.
The Heaven's Gate Collection Agency is assembling a non-profit anti-tribute compilation called
FU2,
which will feature many local Toronto bands and unusual personalities. Shredding, Bono, The Edge, and those other two guys. You two could be a part of this project if you respond with enough spontaneous creative malice and, oh yes, lots of hate. That's Father Illuminato. Box 14102. Yes, I'm talking to you and not
you two.
I'm calling from Toronto Personals, and unfortunately I have to cancel this ad, basically for actually several reasons, the first and foremost of which is the contest you're apparently having, regardless of whether or not it's in jest and it's for amusement only. Those types of ads are not permitted on the service, as well the electronic alterations you've done to the voices on your ad don't really come up very well over the phone. I had a hard time hearing exactly what you're saying, and if I can't hear what you're saying, then the ad isn't acceptable for play on the service. So you'll have to re-record an ad, and we'll try and get it on the service for you as soon as possible. Thank you.
Public domain. Raw material for your reuse. Raw material for your reuse. Go right ahead. Make a buck. It's all yours. No permission or clearance of any kind is necessary. Go right ahead. Do anything you want with raw material for your reuse. That's clear. Of course, you just can't beat the island corporate lawyers behind the artists. Go ahead and try.
You eat lucky charms? Hey! It's Bono! He's got the green clovers. No.
They're magically delicious. Hey, it's Bono. He's got his fly shades on. How could you see anyone through these things, Bono?
There's something that you don't want to see, Gar.
You mean me?
No, you're very cool. You're all right.
Hey, I can't believe I'm talking to Bono. I think I'm gonna hurl.
Don't do it. We don't want you blowing chunks all over Kurt Loder now, do we?
Hey, Bono. You sound funny. Do you eat Lucky Charms?
Blue stars, but not the green clovers, no.
They're magically delicious. Hey, Bono.
Hey.
I can't blame on you. I didn't mean to.
Hey.
No. Book me or book me. No, you're not booking us. In fact, I hear you playing the drums, man.
Hey. I can't believe I'm talking to Bono. I think I'm gonna hurl.
No, you're not putting us back there.
Governor Clinton doesn't think foreign policy is important, but anyway, he's trying to catch up. You may have seen this in the news. He was in Hollywood seeking foreign policy advice from the rock group, U2. Now, understand I have nothing against U2. You may not know this, but they try to call me at the White House every night during the concert. But the next time we face a foreign policy crisis, I will work with John Major and Boris Yeltsin, and Bill Clinton can consult Boy George. I'll stay with the experts.
That Bono should be shot in the name of love, and hey, that'd make a real bloody Sunday, which would be great in my books. Vote for that U2's dead club. Call me back.
There are 50 million blank cassettes a year sold in this country, and believe me, they're not being used for dictation. They're being used to copy records. It doesn't matter whether you want to sell them, give them away, or hand them to every third passerby on Yonge Street. The act of reproduction itself is the reproduction of a song on a tape that triggers the obligations under the Copyright Act.
Well, that's very interesting.
We're the people who can be ripped off the easiest because we can't stop other people from ripping ourselves off. and I get a little bit riled when I see people say that their particular dissatisfaction with the artistic behavior of an act entitles them to, quote, mutilate the song as much as possible, unquote. I'm sorry, this is the result of people's hard work. This is the result of creative effort. And if you have any respect for the creative act, you must respect copyright, and you must respect the role of the creator. I really don't care about the artistic goals of your project. And when he explained the nature of the project, I said, the odds of your getting approval to use masters or approval to use parody lyrics or medleys are going to be extremely low. So unless you're doing just straight covers, the project would not likely get off the ground. And you know, people don't listen to DATs or CDs or tapes or even radio. People listen to music. People really don't care how it gets them. If you make it convenient and cheap and affordable and accessible, they'll use your medium. But otherwise, they're not listening to those airwaves. They're listening to music. Home taping robs the entire music industry of hundreds of millions of dollars a year in revenue. Even the most lucrative possible home taping regime won't repatriate more than 10% of that. Every time someone time shifts a TV show at home on their VCR, that is an offense. There is no exemption from copyright for home taping, period, without the consent of the owner. You may not like the big multinational corporations. You may not like the image that a big band is projecting with its presence or its marketing or whatever. No one's saying you have to. But unless you're willing to have a system where the big guy's rights are just as important as the little guy's rights, nobody has any rights.
You have a message from Box 8053.
That sounds like really cool. Speaking fast and real slow, and then fast and real slow about U2. What do you got against U2? U2 is a pretty good band. I don't listen to it, but it's a pretty good band.
Tape is rolling.
Thank you.
message from box 4703.
Cool ad. What are you into, by the way? Are you into a trip on the wild side with a hot guy?
Listen. you are now being billed on a per minute basis.
You too have been affected by U2. You too can walk away.
Yes, dear friends, this is Reverend Ivan Stang, and this is my deposition. Now, you know, here in the Church of the Subgenius, we don't believe in coincidence or synchronicity, because things like that aren't accidents. They're the doings of Bob. But Bob, I'm afraid, seems to have a damned weird and maybe you might even call hideously cruel sense of humor. Now, Negativland and the basic original 13 apostles of the church have been staunch allies in the Nameless Mission since 1984, when Negativland opened for Bob Dobbs' first assassination, literally. Now, recently, last night in fact, Negativland played New York illegally, of course, and old 13th apostle Reverend Bleepo Abernathy met them for the first time backstage. When he introduced himself, the band fell on their knees, for it seems that Bleepo has unwittingly been the source of the original Casey Kasem tape falling into their hands. They've gotten it from 13th Apostle Byron Werner, who'd gotten it from Bleepo, the mysterious Bleepo, who Negativland finally met. The real irony is that Bleepo had to inform the band that he was now employed by the band U2, in a non-musical type production that I am not at liberty to discuss. But anyway, that's not the end of the circus of ironies. Now, a couple of years ago, about 1 week before I learned of Island and SST's and U2's cowardly betrayal, and I might say blasphemous persecution of the noble Negativland, I had signed on with Island Video for them to distribute our low-budget Subgenius feature video, Arise, which is very Negativland-like, and in fact features some Negativland music, original stuff they did with our live shows. Now, on top of that, our video is almost 50% composed of copyright infringements. But I was kind of chagrined that we'd signed on with the enemy, you know. However, shortly after that, the guy who signed us on was fired, and Island Video realized in total horror what they were now distributing. In fact, they were so terrified that they would get their butts sued because of the shameless sampling, which we did in our video. They were so terrified, friends, that they had to buy an insurance policy, or they thought they had to buy one, to protect them from copyright lawsuits on our account, which cost them 30 grand. Fine revenge, considering they've stiffed us financially and paid us a real piddling advance for a rise, thinking they were going to make a quick buck off of Bob. Anyway, shortly after that, Island Video was totally bought out by PolyGram, and everybody there was fired, and they lost the records, and we haven't seen another dime. And what a wonderful world it is, friends, for 2-bit underground weirdos when they try to poke their mutated little heads up into the blinding glare of the conspiracy pink business world. But it doesn't end there. That ain't all. Shortly after Negativland had in all innocence done some minor collaboration with this wealthy Canadian group calling themselves Producers for Bob, that is Nelson Thal and Bob Dean, they found out that we were being ripped off majorly by that selfsame couple of Canadians who, well, if you've ever seen Bob's Media Ecology, that album, that's a counterfeit Bob Dobbs album done without any consultation with us. So it's kind of a lame Marshall McLuhan rehash with the name Bob Dobbs and Church of the Subgenius just pinned onto it. And we don't mind Subgeniuses abusing Bob, but this was a case of two pink boys with inherited money stealing Bob's sweet name just because their names weren't famous enough and because they assumed correctly, probably, that being in Canada, it would cost us more than we could afford to fight them in Canadian courts. So there it is, dear friends. Read it and weep. Negativland gets sued because of a tape given them by the church. The church, meanwhile, unwittingly signs with the conspiracy guys suing Negativland. Meanwhile, Negativland unwittingly collaborates with the conspiracy guys being sued, probably hopelessly, by the church. What a tangled web is weaved, friend, when first we practiced to make an honest buck off of our garage artworks and shoestring religions. Like Bob's always said, my friend, they're out to fuck you. And if they can't fuck you, they'll find a way to make you fuck yourself. Now, I could go on and on about how the conspiracy has ruined not only the music, but the music business itself, biting off its own hand as it force feeds itself, but you already knew all that. So I shall leave you to meditate upon this, and I pray find time for your own slack and your own way to get revenge on all the pinks who are indeed trying to fuck you too over on a daily basis.
You have a message from box 11456.
I have to respond, Erad. I don't even understand a thing on it. All I can hear is, whoa, this is Father's.
Quick, 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 quick Island Records doesn't sue me for playing it.
We're here today at 333 and the letter Y.
How long have you guys been waiting for U2?
For who?
U2.
U2?
You're not waiting for U2.
No.
Yeah. How long have you been waiting for U2?
Who's U2?
How long have you been waiting for U2?
No, I'm not waiting for U2.
Who are you waiting for?
Yes.
We're here at 333 and the letter Y. And you may be asking why.
They deserve to be treated with respect.
Hold yourself a flag under your black under your robe. Make a stand against the plan. Spread your righteous cause. And now you've made it clear. You've got your very own jet. Yeah.
computer logged on to CompuServe.
Hi, it's Angela. What's wrong? You didn't get back to me. Is something wrong?
Messages are erased after 48 hours.
Hi, this is Susie. Just a little advice. Your ad is so loud, at first it almost blasts your eardrums out, and it's very hard to understand. If you want any females to take you seriously, I would suggest you try again.
Sit here in my Steel Wheels sweatshirt writing this article, realizing the end of an era. I have just attended my last mega rock concert on November the 3rd in Vancouver. I took in the U2 concert. I must have been the oldest person in the audience, but that's okay. I can stand on two chairs for 2 hours, no problem. The problem was U2. With all the technology available, they still can't get the sound right. I was peed off, and that was just the beginning. In interviews, you two always come off as a bunch of guys who care about their fans, the environment, politics, the quality of their songwriting, and delivering a dynamic performance. These guys are the most hypocritical group I have ever seen, more so than Guns N' Roses, and like, at least those types of groups don't hide their intentions or attitudes. So, basically, so I can get all of this done in one throw, if you two cared about the message, they might have delivered something timely or Canadian, or at least international. They flashed the American flag on the screens at the end of the concert as the kids roared. They flashed Martin Luther King Jr. and again the kids roared. Probably didn't even understand why or what he stood for. They knew the country they were in. Why didn't they deal with Canadian politics on those screens? As a matter of fact, they did. If you watch very carefully on the readograph, they did. This mega tour was designed to make megabucks. The rock and roll industry cannot overcome the sound quality for mega shows and couldn't have the band play five nights in some other venue so that they could get better sound. No, I'm a big fan of U2. I think they write and record great music. If I'm wrong, why incorporate Zoo TV into the program if not for broadcast of the tour on music stations of the future? Sell, more mega bucks. Maybe I'm just too old for mega concerts. Could that be? What do you guys think?
You are absolutely obnoxious. Rock on, dude. And have fun experimenting with your drugs.
We're stealing the Beatles. We'll be right back.
happens to be
my personal property.
That is crime, and crime must be dealt with forcefully.
Stop!
Law and order.
Your attention, please. At the recommendation of the International Time Bureau, commencing at 23 hours, 59 minutes, 60 seconds UTC, an extra second will be inserted into the NBS time scale.
All right, Peter. All right, Peter.
Copyright.
That is crime.
Time.
The owner of a copyright has certain exclusive rights regarding the use of a musical work.
Time.
This means that he or she is the only person
time
that can make copies of the work or perform it in public,
time,
and is the only person that can authorize others to do the same. If a person exercises these rights without
time
the copyright holder's consent, that is called copyright and is subject to civil and criminal proceedings.
This way I can personally see that you're persecuted to the full extent of the law.
All right, Peter.
Are you ready to do some time
right,
with
Peter
me and
copyright
be
free? All right,
listen,
Peter.
I've done so much time.
All right,
what
Peter
wears me.
That is crime.
Time.
You're watching your wrists and puts in a bracelet. It's
time
about time.
Mr. McGinnis, I recently attended the Sunday, September 2nd U2 concert at Exhibition Stadium in Toronto. I have been a supportive fan of U2 since 1980 and a propaganda member since its inception. I obtained 4 front row tickets to the above show due to my involvement with propaganda, and it was my first time ever in the front row for any U2 show. I invited 3 good friends to attend the show with me and eagerly awaited the Zoo TV event. However, a situation occurred during the show which was thoroughly disappointing. I was so maddened by it that I had to let my views be known to you. Just as the acoustic portion of the set was to begin, 3, to paraphrase Bono, Marilyn Monroe of Toronto-type women were escorted down through the security area between the stage and fan seating by event security personnel. They were then lifted by security over the barrier right into where my 3 guests and I had our seats. We were edged out of the way with no explanation by anyone. I approached a security guard to inquire about what was happening and to inform him of my displeasure about it. His exact reply was, "Nothing I can do about it. The band wants them there." I could not believe it. Here I was, a huge fan, holding tickets obtained by the band organization, being punted out of the way by 3 women who did not have tickets and were only there because of their look. I was extremely pissed off. I did not think things like this happened at U2 shows. I was quite embarrassed in front of my friends. To top it off, when Bono decided it was time to get a fan up on stage to dance, he made a beeline over to these 3 ladies, and the security guards yanked one of them up on stage. When she came back, she was given a backstage pass by someone from the stage crew. Coincidence? I think not. I guess the 2 women I was with and all the other female ticket-buying fans around me weren't good enough to be seen on stage with Bono. God, Bono. Mr. McGinnis, I do not want to accuse you of something which you had no involvement. I have no facts to back this up, but witnessing this whole scenario unfold only leads me to believe that it was organized and condoned by the top level of U2's organization. U2 are a carefully packaged and crafted myth. Like all myths, they can easily be shattered. I am not that naive to think U2 are holier than thou. I was happy to see them all lighten up and have a bit of fun. The whole concept of Zoo TV is fascinating and a good breath of fresh air. However, the sincerity of U2 and its organization, which I always thought was true, came crashing down in one fell swoop. How does the organization on one hand justify support for Amnesty International, Greenpeace, starving people in the world, let alone other world injustices, while on the other hand practice this injustice towards its own fans at its own show? The connotations, not to mention blatant hypocrisy, of what transpired are thoroughly disheartening. I have lost all respect for the band and its organization, and I'm mad as hell for being so rudely treated. This total lack of consideration for your real fans is inexcusable. I suspect U2 made many new fans from its shows in Toronto, but it also lost 4 longtime fans through the ugliness we witnessed before our eyes. The end.
Thank you. is Anna. I was wondering how old you are. And by the way, what's wrong with the group U2? Let me know at box 8916.
Nothing new.
Yeah, I'm getting stuff together, no problem, you know.
Just want
to do.
Come on, let's
do
it.
No. Oh. Oh, well.
This is American Top 40.
I have climbed the highest mountains.
Yeah, I believe it's the weather, man.
And guess what?
Where you at?
I've run through the fields only to be with you. Yep, with you. No one else, just you.
Here's the first Top 40 hit.
And guess what?
For the Irish band from Dublin who call themselves U2.
I have run, I have crawled, I have scaled these city walls. Yeah, that's really great. I can't believe I did it, but nevertheless, I have done that for you.
That's the letter U and the numeral, too.
Only to be with you, I've done all these things. Yeah, with you. The fat one, that's it. You're the fat one, and I want to be with you.
What's the matter? Can I say, why was it changed here?
But, on the other hand, I still haven't found what I'm looking for.
That's the letter U and the numeral, too.
Maybe they'll make it as a junior.
But, on the other hand, I still haven't found what I'm looking for.
That's the letter U and the numeral.
Nope, definitely not.
Two.
I haven't found it.
They're kind of like
I just can't seem to find it.
That's the letter U and the numeral, too.
Nope, definitely not. I haven't found it.
That's the letter U and the numeral, too.
Come on.
And here's what else I've done.
Come on, let's see what we can find.
I have kissed honey lips, felt the healing in her fingertips. I've even done that.
That's the letter U and the numeral, too.
While I was doing that, you know, all the kissing on the honey lips, it burned like fire, and it reminded me of cheap melting plastic, the kind that makes little clouds of white vapor gas, and then when it catches on fire, makes those little strings of black smoke with little ashes attached to them. That's how it was kissing honey lips.
Why are we doing it? Why have we changed something?
I still haven't found it.
The last thing we want to do is sound like anybody else. So, if you
That's
two,
the letter U and the numeral, too.
You've got to challenge me, you know, musically speaking. You know, you've got to find new sounds on the guitar. You've got to find a new way of approaching a 4-4 beat. You know, rock and roll still needs innovation, you know, and there's a lot out there.
Someone has said, get a great ideal, a great purpose, marry it, and raise a family.
What the hell's going on here?
Bono.
Yeah, I should be saying American Top 40 is heard.
Are you two married to a great idea?
It was every week American Top 40 is heard.
Everything
heard
is topsy-turvy.
Is it to just screw up things?
Marriage is not you two living for each other.
Because I can't say this. You know,
let's see what we can find.
Everything's such a mess.
I thought we were almost finished.
It is you two uniting to live as a team for this great purpose.
Ponderous? Is Don on the phone?
Hi, Casey. I had to put me right on the speakerphone for you. Now, I just got word from Mr. Friday that we can't pay you anything for this until our label sends us some of the money of yours. So this will have to be benefit terms.
Golly, Miss Molly.
Well, I gotta catch a plane. Give my regards to the weatherman, and you too.
You know, they do this to me all the time. I don't know what the hell they do it for, but...
Yeah, the guy that's talking to the ceremony, bring it back.
Now, Megan, and I also want to know what happened to the pictures I was supposed to see this week.
Hey, sewer mouth.
KCA, I'm on a frequency. I bet you can't find me. We've got the fly band out there.
That's the letter, too, and the numeral, U.
I was a worm in the night. And cold as a stone I was.
All right. Okay, let's try it, okay?
And I believe in Kingdom Come.
Okay.
And all the colors bleeding into one big mess.
Okay.
I'll probably have to get out the STP cleaner on that one. Maybe the 409, but I'm not sure yet.
Bye.
That's the letter U and the numeral 2.
And you broke the bond. You broke the goddamn bonds. You loosened the chains. You carried across. And my shame. And my shame. Shame, 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 shame. So much shame.
Yeah.
Why have we changed something that we've been doing all along?
You know, I believe it.
All right.
No, I guess I don't believe it. I don't know what I'm talking about.
This is blowing.
But nevertheless, I still haven't found it.
That's the letter U.
I haven't found what I'm looking for. I haven't found it.
I can't
I'm
say it again.
I'm looking for it, but I don't even know where it is.
And the numeral, too.
I don't even really know anything anymore. I just...
Yeah, it doesn't sound right either.
I don't really know what to do.
All right.
Or do I?
Okay, let's try it, okay?
But I still haven't found it.
That's the letter U and the numeral, too.
That makes sense, but I still haven't found it. I'm looking. I'm looking for it.
That's the letter U and the numeral, too.
I just don't know much of anything. Maybe I ought to be shot point blank in the stamper tonight.
That's the letter U and the numeral, too. Is that the way I say that? I don't know how to say it.
You too. I still haven't found
what
I'm looking for.
Don't be triggered. There it is.
We're counting down the 40 biggest hits in the 50 states.
Hey, sewer mouth, we're gonna get you.
This is American Top 40. This is American Top 40. God, I hate that. We come out of that, and then I gotta say the goddamn American. I hear the American Top 40 jingle, and I say, this is American Top 40. Let the goddamn jingle ID this show. I ID the show whenever there isn't a jingle, don't I?
The winner is...
Don't I do it between every goddamn record that we play?
It is set!
Now, we're up to our long-distance dedication. And this one is about kids and pets and a situation that we can all understand, whether we have kids or pets or neither. It's from a man in Cincinnati, Ohio. And here's what he writes. Dear Casey, this may seem to be a strange dedication request, but I'm quite sincere, and it'll mean a lot if you play it. Recently, there was a death in our family. He was a little dog named Snuggles, but he was most certainly a part of... Let's come, start again. From coming out of the record. Play the record, okay? Please. That's the letter U and the numeral 2. The four-man band features Adam Clayton on bass, Larry Mullen on drums, Dave Evans, nicknamed The Edge, on... This is bullshit. Nobody cares. These guys are from England, and who gives a shit?
Oh, yeah.
Just a lot of wasted names that don't mean diddly shit.
For sure. You don't know where he's at. Don't make shit about you.
This is bullshit.
Sounds like he's portable, yeah.
Who gives a shit?
Diddly shit.
Nobody cares.
It's getting stronger all the time here.
Snuggles.
Yeah.
Snuggles.
Oh, yeah.
Snuggles.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
He was a little dog named Snuggles. This is American Top 40. This is American Top 40. This is bullshit.
This is bullshit.
And then you gotta go into somebody dying. God damn it, if we can't come out of a slow record, I don't understand it. Why are we doing these instrumentals? Because we got them? I don't understand it.
This is all
I don't understand it. This is also nothing new. I don't understand it. I think that people read more into the music than is really there. Will somebody find out the goddamn answer? In the 50s, they considered it vulgar and despicable to have songs like Teach Me Tonight, Let's Do It by Cold Water, all of them by Cold Water. Those were considered euphemisms for something dirty.
Who gives a shit?
Some vulgar, dirty act. Diddly shit. The Kingston Trio thing, if only used the word damn, was banned on the radio. God damn it. In the 60s, it was a song called Louie Louie. God damn it. Upside back. God damn it. Every way they could play it, looking for the dirty message. God, they never found the dirty message. The FCC was brought in.
Oh, fuck.
In the 70s, people went through the same experience, looking for the dirtiness of the song. I really don't think that the satanic message is there. Goddamn concerted effort to come out of a record that isn't a fucking up-tempo record every time I do a goddamn death dedication. It's a last goddamn time I want somebody to use his fucking brain to not come out of a goddamn record that is, that's up-tempo and I gotta talk about a fucking dog dying.
I gotta get some fucking with so much shit.
Silver shithead again.
Who knows? You might be the straightest kid in town.
What is this fucking ponderous, man? Ponderous. Fucking ponderous. This is American Top 40, right here on the radio station you grew up with. Music Radio 138. Oh, fuck.